But anyway, if you ever get caught on that, the thing you want to and point out, and they say, well, this is the same word. Yes, the translator is translated because one has to do with what God says you're going to do, and the other is down here upon the earth that you should, and so forth. But it says the same thing. Every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ, Lord, to the glory of God, and so forth. And then if it says in verse 12, wherefore, my beloved, ye have always obeyed, not as in my presence only, but now much more in my absence, work out your own salvation with fear and trembling. How can you work it out if you don't have it in you? And the next verse says that, for it is God which worketh in you both to will and to do his good pleasure. So you work out your salvation because you have the salvation within you in the person of the Holy Spirit and so forth. So you're not working it out. You're not working it to get it, or that would be working to get it in. No, you're working it out because you already have it. And verse 13 clarifies that, for it is God which worketh in you both to will and to do his good pleasure. Do all things without murmuring and disputing, so forth. Okay, so much for that. And that is, I've got one more scripture. Let's go over here to 1 Timothy chapter 5. And you can just put this down in reference to these things here. 1 Timothy here in chapter 5, okay? 1 Timothy chapter 5. Look in verse 24 and 25, okay? Some men's sins are open beforehand, going before to judgment. Some men, they follow after. Likewise also, the good works of some are manifest beforehand, and they that are otherwise cannot be hid. But, and that's at the judgment seat of Christ, there are a lot of things that some men or Christians do. They don't get any credit for it down here at all, and nobody really sees, except maybe somebody else that's involved they've done good things for. And we have men who want to give out the turkeys and so forth. That's good. We wanted to do that, so we gave those out. We gave out three of them. I couldn't think. It was just, you know, we couldn't give them out to everybody, but I tried to pick out, you know, the best I could. I didn't have time to be delivering turkeys, and then the one person I delivered it to, they had no place to put it. Everything was full. And I said, oh, man. So I had to take that one back and find somebody else. And I'm thinking, oh, man, I don't have time for this. But anyway, they gave them out, and which was wonderful. And the people I know really appreciated it. They did. But not a lot of people know that. And they said, please don't say who gave them. We just like to do this. Well, they'll get rewarded at the judgment seat of Christ. But not everybody knows that, you know. You see. Okay, so much, that's the end of the test. Do you have any questions whatsoever? Yeah. Only if it's an easy one. Oh, yeah, here we go, just for me. Yeah.
He said that,
did I?
Our rewards are going to be eternal.
Eternal.
Our crowns will be eternal?
Why not? Well, you don't get them until you get into heaven.
Why are they casting them at the Lord's feet then?
Because of their gratefulness to him. But they already got them.
Yeah, but I mean, we don't keep them for eternity. We give them to him just out of respect.
Well, here's the thing. You're absolutely right. But it doesn't mean I can't pick them up, put them back on. It just shows I'm grateful to the Lord and throwing him at his feet. If it wasn't for you, none of this would be possible. And another thing is, it's not so much just the literal crowns that are given. I think that's given for us to know, and they are given as rewards we have here for things we do. But they're rewarded for what they did. The crown is just an external thing that they have. So they throw that at his feet, but they're rewarded for all through eternity for what they have done. Irregardless of the crown. But the crown is what God says you're rewarded for. I want to crown you. Aren't we kings and priests with God? Okay. Does a king wear a crown? Does a queen wear a crown? Okay. Then explain to me why there's neither male nor female when we're in heaven. Okay. Never mind. I'm just joking. I'm just kidding. But no, it's a good question. But it's the act that got the crown. It's what gets rewarded eternally. Not the fact that you can throw the crown down there and give it back, but he's just saying, dear Lord, really, you know, this is wonderful, but I loved you, and I served you, and truthfully, nothing's possible if you hadn't put your feet on solid ground and took on human flesh and come down here and die for me, I wouldn't even be here. So I think all that, when you get thinking about it, I think if I would ever get a crown, then I know I get one because I look for his coming, and that's one of the crowns. So I know I got that one. I know I got a soul winner's crown because I've led some people to the Lord. How many? Who knows? I don't know. Good night. Yep. I don't know. But I know this. When I get to heaven, I'll probably do the same thing. I'll be so happy to see the Lord and have a new body and never be sick and sorrow death and see the cherubim, seraphims, and everything that's in heaven and so forth, the second Jerusalem. I'd throw him at his feet too. Considering I'm a human being, I shouldn't even be here. You know? And here you're giving me a crown for just serving you while I was down there on the earth. And we'll look from heaven down here and this will just be like a little marble rolling around compared to our time here upon the earth. And we'll probably think, oh, I could have done so much more. And I didn't. You know? I know I feel that way many times. You know? But isn't that wonderful though? I think it is. So I think the crown means absolutely. And he could give me two crowns, one soul winning, but I've had fun doing it. You know, I've had fun shaking up those that didn't trust the Lord. I had a lot of fun doing that. You know? And I relate. The only reason I relate that is to get men to realize you can do something. You don't have to be ashamed. You don't have to be scared. You don't have to be anything. You're the King of Kings as your Heavenly Father. You have a home in heaven. You're speaking about people on their way to hell. And especially, now I'm not that way with the people. I'm not that way at all. But, well, I'm not saying not at all, unless it's smart or something like that. But I'm talking about leaders, the leaders, and I'll specify that more. The leaders, not the people. There are some nice people that go to the Lutheran Church. There's some nice people that go to the Catholic Church. When I say nice, they're good fathers. They're good husbands, they're good wives, they're good mothers, and they're nice people. They don't go around trying to hurt everybody and do dirty things and everything else. There are some that do. But there are some nice people. But those are not the people that I really get on. I try to lead them to the Lord and do the best I can and leave them that I didn't... really attack them. I'm just trying to relate to them how I believe you go to heaven. I can show it to you in the Bible. But the false leaders and the priest and the Lutherans and any false leader, doesn't make any difference who it is. Jehovah's Witness or what? Or Mormons when they come around. I'm very nice to the Mormons when they come around. Those young men are very nice and so forth. They're very respectable and so forth. And I always treat them with the utmost respect. But I always tell them the truth. You know, you're not going to heaven here. And I point out some things about Mormonism there. So those are not the kind that I'm the kind of guy that you may think I am. But give me the leaders of it. And I'm like a Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde. Because I have no use for them because they're the ones sending them to hell, see. And if they can send them to hell, then I can be as strong against them as they are against the people. And I think we should be as a Christian. So if I relate what I do, it's not for, oh, look how great I am or anything like that. It didn't mean a thing to me because I do a lot of things I don't relate, you know. But I relate some of that when I do it. And there is to give them courage. Hey, you don't have to take a back seat to anybody. Jesus Christ, you're on your way to heaven, you know. What do you got to be ashamed of? You want to run with the crowd? Well, the love of the world is enmity with God, isn't it? I don't want to be like the world. I already did that a few years. You know, that got me in more trouble I ever seen in my life, you know. And nobody listened to me, and I followed them. That was a big mistake. Well, they wouldn't must have listened to because I said the same thing they said. Okay, do you have any more questions? Anybody else got anything? One? Okay, who wants to close in prayer? Would you like to close in prayer, Dave? Go ahead.